Hey everybody, it's Jang here with a look at a LEGO Minecraft set. This is the Snow Hideout. It comes with 327 pieces. And you see it's in a very, very cold place. We've got a lot of snow and the player has built up an igloo type of enclosure there, housing unit. A little bit of water off to the side, some ice also built up. This thing is actually built up pretty decently around the sides and around the back. Even the side that's not photographed for the pictures. Usually most of the focus is put on one side or two sides, you know, basically one corner view. But this has nice shaping all the way around it. I appreciate that. Got a tree off to the side, which is representing a small spruce tree, and it's built in a, you know, not particularly realistic way, but it's going with the scaled down size that they use for these sets so that you get the feeling of the thing, the look of the thing, without having to use, you know, 100, 200 blocks to make it realistic. Little bit of a fence over here off the side, just for decoration, I think. A little bit of grass that has shown up right there. This is an action feature right here, so if you bring in a creeper who is creeping up on you, he can actually explode right there. You push down right here and everything explodes. He comes up with it, and these are just some snow blocks that come blasting out of that, and down beneath it's just some dirt, so that makes sense. My favorite thing here is definitely this water section, which has ice, and the ice is made with transparent medium blue 2x2 bricks, not transparent light blue, transparent medium blue. It's a rare and glorious, glorious color. It looks so delicious to me, so beautiful. I love it. And you get a bunch of those bricks in this set. It's a little bit awkward that the ice is up above the level of the water, but you know, it's what they had to do, because they weren't gonna fill all this in with all blocks to pull that off, because that just would have added in a lot more pieces without really adding a lot of value and detail to the set. A couple of blocks of coal ore over here that you can mine out that are conveniently exposed. You got some water here. I'm assuming that the water has just been melted from snow, the way that it's up above ground and it's flowing down. More of those trans-medium blue pieces are the bricks, the 2x2 bricks, are used on the house itself, the enclosure. And it has the nice standard LEGO Minecraft brick-built door, which still looks really good. And you probably saw as I was spinning this around that the thing has a hinge on it. So yes, it's another one of those sets that opens up. It can be hinged open like so. And over on this side, nothing, you know, the back side of it, really nothing there. Would have been nice to throw just a bed right there. They didn't put one in. They have a block of netherrack here with a fire on it, so you've got your perpetual fire right there, and then just a printed crafting table inside of it, and that's all you get in there. But there's also a chimney up on top made of what is that? What is that supposed to represent? It's not cobblestone. I think that's I'll have to look it up, or somebody or 100 people can say what it's supposed to be by looking it up on the chart. And you can just leave a comment about that. But this is a snow golem up here. Has printed pieces on the front. So that's a tile, and that's a 1x2 brick. And I think this is a really smart design. Giving us the brown colored stud shooters. I don't like the stud shooters in general, but this is a really great use of them. Allows you to fire off little snowballs, just like a snow golem actually would do. The proportions are a little bit off here, but it's not that bad. I think it's well done for, you know, for LEGO, for using actual normal LEGO parts. I think this is a really smart design of a figure, you know, built up figure in this case. And it uses the same pumpkin head piece that can be also placed on regular minifigures, so you can swap that out. Or, you know, it's just fitting on top of a stud, so you can just put it down as a pumpkin anywhere that you want. So a very reusable piece there. And again, just I think a really smart design for this. And you put it on a jumper plate and it's able to just rotate around and aggravate anybody who's coming in, you know, to get their attention. I like that. It's kind of smooth the way that it spins around too. Now I do like the way this looks from this side when you open it up. You know, you actually use the hinge there, because with the way that it's built up on the back, this looks like additional terrain. So it gives you more believable play space. Another thing that they allow you to do here is take the entire roof section off, because it's attached with, what is it, just a couple of studs? Yeah, just a couple of studs with jumper pieces. And this is all the stuff that's intended to be taken apart. Well, this and also the water section over here can also be taken off, and you can place that different places if you want to. But these two assemblies are intended to be taken apart for your rebuild inspiration in the manual here. Shows you take all the individual things apart except for the kind of pre-made blocks and pieces. Rebuild all that together to create something different. And it just gives you a little bit more of a play area, you know, a whole mining kind of scenario where you go around. You can see this as being part of a cave or just a little depression, you know, it just kind of goes down. Still the door there is a little bit awkward. Maybe you could just see this as being your enclosure. I think it's not the most inspired look overall, but it does show you very clearly that you have a lot of blocks, just regular plain pieces that are easy to turn into other different things. Of course, you saw by now the main figure is just a plain Steve with no armor on, and he's got a wooden pickaxe, and you also get just a regular creeper, same creeper that we've gotten before. No additional prints to be seen there, and there was also included in the house a wooden shovel. I personally don't really like the snowy areas in-game in Minecraft. I don't particularly like how they look or how they play, but I do like the look of this set. I like the look of this set much better than I would the exact same scenario in-game. I think it just has nice proportions to it, nice shaping, nice, I guess they kind of give you a good range of color here with the watery area and also with the tree out in the front. I especially like those transparent medium blue pieces, of course, but overall I just feel like the set is nicely designed. It gives you nice play space. It really invites you to become a part of this landscape and to interact with it. I feel like it's just nicely balanced between active play features, passive play features, and just kind of the invitation to imagine. I don't know, there's something very difficult to describe. Just mentally for me, it just works. Let me know if it just works for you by leaving a comment down below. Thank you for watching. I hope that I showed you everything you wanted to see about this set. I will be talking to you again very soon.